position change. What is having a displacement? There is a work of force. That is, when we apply a force to an object, and this object having a position change or a displacement occurs, when we say that there is a work is done. Okay. There is a position changing occurs on the same direction of the force applied. And that is known as basically work. And we have needed capacity to do work. When a force is applying, we want a capacity to apply that force. And that capacity is stored in a body is known as the energy that do work. So there is a displacement occurs on a body on the direction of the applied force, that is known as the work. And the capacity to do work, that is stored in the form of energy. And what is power? Power is the work that occurs per time or rate of change of time. That is, when a work is done in a particular time, that is known as power. So basically, these all are power, work and energy. I think all of you know that what is the basis of work, power and energy. Work is that if a body have a displacement on the same direction of the applied force, that is work. The energy or the capacity stored in one body is known as the energy. Work doing in per unit time is known as power. So next we have to discuss it through slide for more about work. Work is said to be done only when a body undergoes a displacement in the direction of the applied force. That we have discussed that work is done if when a force is applied on one direction and a displacement is occurs at the same direction. An object undergoes displacement only when force is applied on the earth. If a work is to be done only when a force is applied to the earth. If a force of F Newton is applied continuously on a body and the body undergoes a displacement of S meter in the direction of the force, then the work done by the applied force is W is equal to F into S. And joule is the unit of work. Okay? Only work is to be done when an amount of force is applied on a body and there is a displacement occur. Only when a force is applied on a body and there is when a force is applied on an object, there occurs a displacement or position changing from the initial position rest to a final position. There is a displacement of the when force is applied on a body, there is a displacement of the and that is known as the work. Okay. When work is to be done only when a force is applied and a displacement occurs. When the amount of force applied is taken as F and the displacement occur is taken as S meter. Force is applied is taken as F Newton and the displacement is occur as S meter. The work is done is equal to W is equal to F. F into S. So this is the equation showing work. And the unit of work is joule. Okay. So next we have to discuss the other topics. The slide. When a body is raised to a height h, the work done against the gravitational force would be W is equal to mgh. W is equal body of mass 100 gram to a height of 1 meter. When a body on a floor is pulled and if it's displaced in the direction of the applied force, the work done by the applied force will be positive and the work done by the frictional force exerted by the floor will be negative. Okay. Now we are discussing that a body having a displacement when a force is applied. This displacement is occur in length and a displacement that occur in height. We are lifting a body, the displacement is occur in height. At that time the work is done to be W is equal to mgh. That is the mass of the body into the gravitational force into height of the body that are displaced. Okay, so a body having a displacement in length, the work that is W is equal to F into S. The body having a displacement in terms of height, and that is known as W is equal to mgh. And 1 joule of work is done in one condition, that is the height of the object is rising 1 meter and that object having 100 gram weight. A body of 100 gram weight lifting a height of 1 meter when the work done here is 1 joule. Okay, so 1 joule is equal to 100 gram weight into 1 meter distance in height. That is 1 joule. And we are giving a force or pulling a body in a floor that having a displacement. A body is sitting here and we pulling that body is changing a position. We are applying a force on the object is having a displacement. And here is a positive force and negative force. What is the positive force? The applied force here is the positive force. What is the positive force? The applied force. We are applying a force on a body that is sitting in a floor and is having a displacement, and the applied force is positive and the negative force is experiencing here, that is the frictional force. We are giving an applied force that is positive and we are experiencing a force against the floor, and that is known as the frictional force, and the experiencing frictional force is negative. So the applied force is positive and the frictional force experiencing here is known as the negative force. So I think all of you understand what is the work done of a body when it is lifted up, and what is 1 joule of work, and what is the positive and negative forces experiencing on a body when we pulling a body that is sitting in a floor. Okay, next we have to discuss the other topics. The slide. what is kinetic energy? Just like. Kinetic energy of a body. The energy possessed by a body by virtue of its motion is the kinetic energy. A body is in motion, is having an energy, then that energy is the kinetic energy. For deriving an equation for kinetic energy, first of all we are considering the work is done in a body, and that is taken as W is equal to Fs. And we know that F is equal to ma, that is the Newton's second law of motion. And we apply that W is equal to F, when we add in F is equal to ma, so the equation is changing, W is equal to mas. And we have an equation, the second equation of motion, that is B square is equal to U square plus 2as. And the initial velocity of a body is equal to a zero, then b square is comes to 2as. B square is equal to 2as. The initial velocity of that body is taken as zero. The equation is changed as b square is equal to 2as. From here, as is equal to b square by 2. And we add the as in the equation. W is equal to mas. So, W is equal to m into b square by 2 minus W is equal to m into b square by 2. And from this, we are rearranging this equation. That is like W is equal to half m b square. And the work that is here is taken as the kinetic energy because the body is in motion. When a body of mass m moves with a velocity v, its kinetic energy will be k is equal to half mc square. That is, from here we can know that k is equal to half mc square is the equation that showing the kinetic energy of a body. Okay, when we are considering the kinetic energy of a body, that is the energy that possessed in a body by virtue of it is in a motion. So the energy in motion is known as kinetic energy. K is equal to half mv square. For understanding K is equal to half mv square, we have W is equal to Fs, that is the work done. And we know that F is equal to ma is the Newton's first law of motion, and we are applying F to this equation, W is equal to Fs, and it changes, W is equal to mas. And now in this equation, we want a substitution for the term as. For finding out this substitution, we are using b square is equal to u square plus 2as is the second equation of motion. From here, we got that as is equal to b square by 2. And adding this substitution to the first equation, w is equal to mas, this equation is changing to w is equal to mb square by 2. And here the work done is the kinetic energy, and W is comes to K, and we got the equation for kinetic energy is that K is equal to half mv square. So this is the equation that showing the kinetic energy of an object. So I think all of you understand what are the topics discussed today. Work, energy and power are the three topics discussing today. Work, the work, ഫ്രിക്ഷൻ പറയുന്നത് ഡബ്ല്യു ഇസ് ഈക്വൽ ടു എഫ് ഇൻറ്റു എസ്, അവിടെ അപ്ലൈ ചെയ്യുന്ന ഫോഴ്സും ഇൻറ്റു അവിടെ അപ്ലൈ ചെയ്യുന്ന ഡിസ്റ്റൻസും. ഫോഴ്സിനെ നമ്മൾ എഫ് എന്ന് എടുക്കുന്നു, ഡിസ്റ്റൻസിനെ നമ്മൾ എസ് എന്ന് എടുക്കുന്നു. സോ ഒരു ഫ്ലോറിലാണ് ഒരു ബോഡിക്ക് വർക്ക് സംഭവിച്ചത് എന്ന് വെച്ചാൽ അതിന്റെ ഇക്വേഷൻ ഡബ്ല്യു ഇസ് ഈക്വൽ ടു എഫ് ഇൻറ്റു എസ്. ഇനി ഒരു ബോഡിയെ നമ്മൾ ലിഫ്റ്റ് ചെയ്യുകയാണ്, അപ്പൊ അതിനുണ്ടാകുന്ന വർക്ക് എന്ന് പറയുന്നത് ഹൈറ്റിലാണ് വർക്ക്. സോ ദാറ്റ് ഈസ് ഡബ്ല്യു ഇസ് ഈക്വൽ ടു എം ജി എച്ച്. അവിടെ നമ്മൾ എടുക്കുന്നത് ബോഡിയുടെ മാസ്, ആക്ട് ചെയ്യുന്ന ഗ്രാവിറ്റേഷണൽ ഫോഴ്സ് ആൻഡ് ദ ഡിസ്പ്ലേസ്മെന്റ്. Displacement here is taken as in the term of height because lift ചെയ്യാണ് അപ്പോൾ ഉണ്ടാകുന്ന വർക്കാണ് ആയതുകൊണ്ട് അതിനെ എച്ച് ഇന്റെ ടേമിൽ എടുക്കും. അപ്പൊ നീളത്തിലാണ് അല്ലെങ്കിൽ ഒരു ഫ്ലോറിലാണ് ഒരു ഒബ്ജക്റ്റിന് ഡിസ്പ്ലേസ്മെന്റ് ഉണ്ടായി വർക്ക് ഉണ്ടായതെങ്കിൽ ഡബ്ല്യു ഇസ് ഈക്വൽ ടു എം. ഹൈറ്റിലാണ് ഒരു ബോഡിക്ക് ഡിസ്പ്ലേസ്മെന്റ് ഉണ്ടായതെങ്കിൽ അതിനെ എം ജി എച്ച്. അപ്പൊ ഇതാണ് വർക്ക് എന്ന് പറയുന്നത്. ഇനി എനർജി എന്ന് പറഞ്ഞാൽ വർക്ക് ചെയ്യാനുള്ള കപ്പാസിറ്റിയാണ് എനർജി എന്ന് പറയുന്നത്. ഒരു ഒബ്ജക്റ്റില് എനർജി സ്റ്റോർ ചെയ്തിട്ടുണ്ടാവും, ആ എനർജി യൂസ് ചെയ്തിട്ടാണ് ആ ഒബ്ജക്റ്റ് വർക്ക് ചെയ്യുന്നത്. ഇനി വർക്ക് എനർജി ഡിഫറെന്റ് ടൈപ്സ് ഓഫ് എനർജി ഉണ്ട്. എനർജി നമുക്ക് ഒരു എനർജിയുടെ ഫോമിൽ നിന്ന് മറ്റൊരു എനർജിയുടെ ഫോമിലേക്ക് കൺവേർട്ട് ചെയ്യാം. ഇപ്പൊ മെക്കാനിക്കൽ എനർജിയുടെ ഫോമിൽ സ്റ്റോർ ചെയ്ത് വെച്ചിട്ടുള്ള എനർജിയെ നമുക്ക് ഇലക്ട്രിക്കൽ എനർജി ആയിട്ട് കൺവേർട്ട് ചെയ്യാം. നമ്മുടെ യൂസസിനനുസരിച്ച് എനർജിയെ നമുക്ക് കൺവേർട്ട് ചെയ്യാം. ഇനി എനർജിയിൽ പറയാനുള്ളത് ടു ടൈപ്സ് ഓഫ് എനർജി ആണ്. ഫസ്റ്റ് വൺ കൈനറ്റിക് എനർജി ആൻഡ് സെക്കൻഡ് വൺ പൊട്ടൻഷ്യൽ എനർജി. മെക്കാനിക്കൽ എനർജി, മെക്കാനിക്കൽ എനർജിയുടെ രണ്ട് ടൈപ്സ് ആണ് ഈ കൈനറ്റിക് എനർജിയും പൊട്ടൻഷ്യൽ എനർജി. ആൻഡ് കൈനറ്റിക് എനർജി ആണ് ടുഡേ നമ്മൾ ഡിസ്കസ് ചെയ്യുന്നത്. ഒരു ബോഡി മോഷനിൽ ആയിരിക്കുമ്പോൾ അതിന് സ്റ്റോർ ചെയ്തിട്ടുള്ള എനർജിയാണ് കൈനറ്റിക് എനർജി. ഓൾറെഡി ബോഡിയിൽ എനർജി ഉണ്ട്, അത് മോഷനിൽ ആവുമ്പോൾ ആ എനർജിക്ക് കൺവേർഷൻ വരുന്നു. നമ്മൾ പറഞ്ഞു എനർജി ഒരു ഫോമിൽ നിന്ന് മറ്റൊരു ഫോമിലേക്ക് കൺവേർട്ട് ചെയ്യാം. അപ്പോ മോഷനിലുള്ള ബോഡിയിൽ സ്റ്റോർ ചെയ്തിട്ടുള്ള എനർജിയെ മറ്റൊരു എനർജി ഫോമായിട്ട് കൺവേർട്ട് ചെയ്യുന്നു, ദാറ്റ് ഈസ് കൈനറ്റിക് എനർജി. And the equation that